أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. إخلاص. Condemnation of Riya. Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, On the day of judgment, sealed books of deeds will be brought and presented to Allah tabaraka ta'ala. And Allah tabaraka ta'ala will say, Throw these for some and accept these for some. The angels will say, By your honor and majesty, O Allah, we have not seen anything in these books except good. To which Allah Azza wa Jal will say, Indeed, those deeds were done not for me, and today I will not accept but those deeds done only for my pleasure. In another narration, the angels will say, By your honor, we have not written but what he had done. Allah will say, You say the truth, but indeed his deeds were not done for my pleasure. Tabrani, Bazzar, Majma'uz Zawaid. Anas radiallahu anhu narrates that indeed Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, The things of destruction are miserliness which is obeyed, that sensual desire which is pursued, and the consideration of a person for himself as being superior to others. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, The things of destruction are miserliness which is obeyed, that sensual desire which is pursued, and the consideration of a person for himself as being superior to others. Bayhaqi. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, The worst of people as regards his rank in the hereafter is he who spoils his life of the hereafter for the worldly benefit of others. The worst of people as regards his rank in the hereafter is he who spoils his life of the hereafter for the worldly benefit of others. Hadith is from Bayhaqi. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, My greatest fear for this ummah is my fear of that hypocrite who is eloquent in speech. My greatest fear for this ummah is the fear of that hypocrite who is eloquent in speech. Bayhaqi. Note, by hypocrite is meant a pretender, meaning a insincere person, or a fasiq, meaning a transgressor of the limits of Allah. The explanation is from Mazahir al-Haq. Abdullah ibn Qais al-Khuzai radiallahu anhu narrates that indeed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, He who engages in a virtuous deeds intending to show off and get fame, he remains under the wrath of Allah until he abandons that intention. He who engages in a virtuous deeds intending to show off and get fame, he remains under the wrath of Allah until he abandons that intention. This hadith comes from Tafsir ibn Kathir. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, He who wears the dress of fame in this world, Allah will clothe him with the dress of humiliation on the day of resurrection and will set it ablaze. Ibn Majah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Da'wat and Tabligh, inviting towards Allah Ta'ala and conveying His message. To correct one's belief and deeds, and for the correction of the belief and deeds of all mankind, one must struggle to revive the effort of da'wah in the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam throughout the world. Verses of Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, And Allah invites to the abode of peace, meaning paradise, and leads whom He wills to a straight path. And Allah invites to the abode of peace, meaning paradise, and leads whom He wills to a straight path. Surah Yunus chapter 10 verse 25. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He, meaning Allah, is who has sent among the unlettered people a messenger from amongst themselves reciting to them his verses, that is, by means of the Quran he invites them, advises them and prepares them to accept Islam, and to purify them from the filth of disbelief and polytheism, and to cultivate excellence in conduct, and teaches them the book and wisdom, meaning the Sunnah, and verily they were most obviously lost in error. Surah Al-Jum'ah, chapter 62, verse 2. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "If He willed, we could raise up a warner in every village in your time and would not have burdened you with the mission single-handedly. But to increase your reward, we have given you this tremendous responsibility, and this is indeed Allah's bounty on you. So obey not the disbelievers, but strive against them by means of the Quran with a great endeavor. The unbeliever will be happy if you do not endeavor for inviting people towards Allah. However, you confront the unbelievers with strong reasoning from the Quran and invite all repeatedly with great vigor." Surah Furqan, chapter 25, verses 51 to 52. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Invite mankind to the way of your Rabb with wisdom, with the reasoning of the Quran and excellent preaching, with softness and humility in a manner which affects the heart." Surah Nahl, chapter 16, verse 125. Note: here some of the basic principles of work of tabligh have been explained in a brief manner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "And remind by explaining and preaching the Quran, for verily reminding benefits the believer. And remind by explaining and preaching the Quran, for verily reminding benefits the believers." Surah Dhariyat, chapter 51, verse 55. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Oh, the one wrapped up in your cloak, arise and warn and magnify your Rabb." Surah Mudassir, chapter 74, verses 1 to 3. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "It may be that you are going to kill yourself with grief because they do not become believers." Surah Shura, chapter 26, verse 3. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "There has come to you a messenger from amongst yourself, and it grieves him much that any harm should come to you. He is full of concern for each one of you, that you may be rightly guided, and for the believers, compassionate and merciful." Surah Tawbah, chapter 9, verse 128. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "So let not your soul expire in grief for them because of their disbelief." Surah Fatir, chapter 35, verse 8. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Verily, we sent Nuh to his people saying, 'Warn your people before painful punishment comes to them.' He said, 'O my people, verily, I am a plain warner to you, bidding you that you serve Allah and keep your duty to Him and obey Me, that He may forgive you some of your sins and respite you to an appointed term. By the blessing of Iman and piety, you will be saved of torment, but not death. Indeed, the term of Allah, when it comes, cannot be delayed. If you but knew, for a long time His people paid no heed to His advice." He said, "My Rabb, verily, I have invited my people night and day, but all my invitation did not add to their repugnance. And indeed, whenever I invited them so that you may pardon them, they thrust their fingers in their ears and covered themselves with their garments so that they may not see me, and persisted in their refusal and magnified themselves in pride. And indeed, I have invited them aloud, and I have made public proclamation to them, and I have appealed to them in private, spared no way to guide them. And I have said, 'Seek pardon of your Rabb. He indeed is ever forgiving. He will open up the sky for you with plentiful rain, and will increase you in wealth and sons, and will give you gardens, and will give you streams. What is wrong with you that you do not take heed of the greatness of Allah whereas He created you in diverse stages? See you not how Allah has created the seven heavens in harmony and has made the moon a light therein and made the sun a lamp? And Allah has caused you to grow as a growth from the earth. And afterwards He makes you return to it. And He will bring you forth again, a new forth bringing. And Allah has made the earth a wide expanse for you, so that you might walk thereon on spacious path. Surah Nuh, chapter 71, verses 1 to 20. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Subhanaka rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Birahmatika ya arhamar rahimeen. La ilaha.